Of course, this year is a bit more a complicated year, as last year the impact of COVID was helping us quite a lot. But we still feel confident with the measures and the investments that we did in our like-for-like portfolio. And if you read the strategy, you will see as well that it's actually focused on improving what we have. Bear in mind that we currently own over 22,000 stores. So there's no way that I can grow my top line more without support of the like-for-like. So I need to focus on my existing base and have tailored growth, either organic or through smart acquisitions, where yes, indeed, we have started last year to be focused very much on value accretive growth and value accretive acquisitions. Looking at the Russian consumer in itself, we've seen, and that's also where the support came from. I think one of the misunderstandings, what I've seen in my career so far, is that we believe that if people get less money, they will start spending their money on cheaper stuff. What I've seen always is that people that have less money will economize, but will actually will more go into value. And if you look at the discounters in Europe, you see as well that they're actually value players and not really the lowest price in itself. And I think that's also what I try to convince Magnitof as an organization. Let's move into value. Let's go for an everyday low price when it comes to our convenience. But with our own production, and bear in mind, we have 13 factories and we have four of the biggest agricultural complexes in Russia as well. Let's make sure that we focus on efficiency and therefore are able to offer our customers a real value proposition, a good price for and a good quality.